Sir, are you okay?
I'm okay. Thank you.
Did you sleep here last night?
Yeah, I was on my way to the shelter. But, this is as far as I could make it because of my war injury.
You're injured? Do you need me to call an ambulance?
No, I'm alright. It's healed up long ago.
Well, I'm on my way to the church. I have a lot of leftovers from last night's banquet. Why don't you let me heat you up some food, make you a cup of coffee, and I'll drive you to the shelter. It's a long walk, but a short drive.
That sounds mighty nice. I think it'll take you up on the offer, Mr.
Michael Winters.
Pleasure to meet you. I'm Captain William Bly.
Happy to do it. I mean, after a banquet like last night, we always have so much food left over. Miss Jones makes enough to feed a small country, so enjoy. So you're captain in what branch?
Air Force, since I was 18.
So how does a captain in the Air Force end up?
Sleeping by a roadside?
Yeah.
Basically giving it all up and not caring what happens to you.
I'm sorry, if you don't want to talk about it, we can talk about something else.
It's been a long time since I've talked about it with anyone. I normally keep to myself. And there was a time when I put my career first. I rose to the ranks quickly and I traveled the world. I sent letters home to my son, my wife often, money when I could. It was during my second tour that I took a wound that got me an honorable discharge. So, I was finally going home. When I got there, I found that my wife was moving in with another man, and that he had been a better father and a better husband than I had ever been. So, that day was the last time I saw my son. There were heated words, and we exchanged anger. And so I was left with a hole in my heart and a hole in my life.
That's quite a story. I'm sorry. What happened next?
Well, I tried to pick up the pieces, but the pieces didn't really fit anymore. I was a disabled vet with mental and physical disabilities, so it was difficult to hold down a job. No one really wants to employ a beat-up war vet with PTSD. And then I thought, well, I did my duty. The system should take care of me. I deserve it, don't I? But the system didn't work. And so here I am with all my worldly goods in this backpack.
What do you keep in that bag? I mean, it's full to the brim.
Just the essentials. But during my travels, I found this. I wanted to give it to my son so that he would know no matter how far away I was thinking about him.
It's a beautiful cloak. I've never seen anything quite like this. I do hope you get to give it to him one day.
So do I, son. So do I.
Hello?
Hey, hon. Sorry I'm late. I've had the most interesting morning.
Oh, is everything okay?
Yeah, everything's fine. I just met a fascinating man, and I'll tell you all about it later.
Okay.
The thing is, he's really down on his luck, and I really want to help him. He's been disconnected from his son for years.
Well, what can we do to help him?
Yeah, I don't know. But we'll make some calls when I get home. I'm on my way now. I love you.
All right, see you in a bit. Love you too. Bye.
The gray I am, immovable rock, omnipotent, powerful, awesome Lord, victorious warrior, commanding King of Kings, mighty conqueror, and the only time. When he ran to me, he took me in his arms, held my head to his chest, said, "My son's come home again," lifted my face, wiped the tears from my eyes, with forgiveness in his voice, he said, "Son, do you know I still love you?"
Hey, how did it go?
You know, I think it went really well. He's going to give me a call next week and let me know if I got the job, but I'm feeling good about it.
That's awesome. That's great.
I really appreciate all of your help.
Yeah, it's really the least we could do. Vicky and I really wanted to help you get back on your feet.
Well, new clothes and a new start and a new job, I really can't thank you enough.
Well, you know, we have one more stop to make before we head home for dinner.
Where are we?
We're at the home of Joshua Bly, recently married, father of one, 25 years old.
What?
It's your son.
Are you sure?
100% sure. I met him yesterday.
What if he won't talk?
Well, that's a risk that you can choose to take. I've opened up the door and you can walk through or not.
How do I look?
Look ready.
It's written down the road that's so uncertain. Now I am left alone and I am broken. Trying to find my way, trying to find the faith that's gone. This time that you are holding all the answers, but I'm tired of losing hope and taking chances on roads that never seem to be the ones that bring me home. Give me a revelation, show me what to do, 'cause I've been trying to find my way.
I'd like to thank you so much. I've been searching for him ever since my daughter was born. I gave up hope.
Dad is such a great man. We just wanted to help him any way we could.
Really, it means everything to us. My family's complete again. It's amazing to have him back in our lives. We're about to have dinner if you want to come inside.
No thanks, I have my own family to get home to, but you guys enjoy each other. You have a lot to catch up on.
Thank you so much.
Father, Father.
Hey, honey, I'm on my way home.
Great. Did everything go okay?
Yeah, it went great. I can't wait to tell you all about it. It's been a really amazing week. Yeah.